Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this episode, I'm going to talk about an ancient Iranian house, which is also a museum. This house dates back to 2 centuries ago, when Qajar's dynasty were ruling over Iran and located in Alavi Street in Kashan city. This place is among rare places that attracts many tourists every year. This house was abandoned for many years until the famous architect Akbar Helli bought it, and he spent 1 year to renovate it. Then this place has been open to tourists. This house consisted of 2 main sections, internal and external part. Each of these parts has subsidiary sections like living room, basement, wind tower, flower beds, waiting rooms, vestibule, balconies, and porch. In that time, architects designed a house in a way that internal part, which designated to nuclear family, to be separated from external part that belonged to visitors and guests. Also, in this method of designing, every house has an underground floor which used in summer season. Having underground floor made the temperature difference, and this in turn made a cool environment. This feature also made the water flow more easily in this house, because in that time water for washing was supplied by aqueducts. In the external section, we have a stone banister and booth overlooking the courtyard. These booths contain some artifacts and handicrafts which were used in that time. There are some statues with native clothes, and each of them designated to show an activity. In every living room, we have colorful windows and doors that open vertically, and they are in odd numbers to double down the beauty of this house. Living rooms were used for holding ceremonies like weddings. You can see in this booth there are some sophisticated tools for making special doors. In that time, people used clay dishes for keeping water in them, because these dishes have perforated body, and that feature let a little water pass through. So the body of the clay dishes became wet, and water in the body absorbed some heat and evaporated, which made the water inside of the clay dishes cooler. Some of these clay dishes glazed with special materials to maintain yogurt or vinegar. Some of these dishes are bigger and were used for holding pickles, especially pickled garlic, for 7 years. There are other dishes for keeping flour or wheat, and a big bowl for baking bread and bread dough. In other parts, there are some niches at each part to hold a lamp. Not to mention that lamps in that time used kerosene as their fuel. We have some booths which contain kitchen utensils like pot or cups made out of copper. People used old chests to keep their clothes in them. Mortars was used as a tool to grind wheat or other materials, and most of them made out of stone to crush hard materials more easily. We have old scale and a well in underground floor. I should mention that drinkable water was supplied by a well during that time. In the kitchen, there is a wooden tool for keeping meats above the ground. In the middle of the living room, we have a stove at the bottom of the floor. This part was full of charcoals during winter time, and they put a table on it to maintain the warm air, and this served as a heater. All carpets and rugs were made by hand due to lack of machinery in the past, which was an arduous activity. In the basement section, we have some special channels which are connected to wind towers. Wind towers catch the wind and guide it through these channels to the basement and thus create a cool place. These places were used in summer season by nuclear family. Also, these places were an appropriate place for keeping perishable foods like meat. Near every basement, there is a pool to lower the temperature of that place. Basement was built out of unique materials to maintain the weight of the whole building. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section. And if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.